I invite you to take a moment to envision yourself loving your work and life.
You come in here and you have to feel good.
I see all these great stories made by these authors and I feel like I can write a story too.
That might sound like a complete fairy tale, but I know it's possible.
Certainly by the end of the 19th century, scientists felt that our fate was predetermined.
He proposed a mathematical model of how this might work and found something surprising. The systems in his model could only be predicted up to a specific point in the future.
Among the scientists, your colleague does some great work. You know how we praise them? We say, your paper is beautiful.
He was a poet as much as he was anything else. And I was swooning of learning about the brain.
There was this nice sunspot on the sun on Monday. And it just shows you what an incredibly active star our sun is.
Lorenz found a set of three equations. Let's try graphing them in three dimensions on a modern computer.
I think the people who are doing art and the science, I think there is a common motivation in there.
They're on this quest for truth and beauty and the celebration of art and friendship in really its purest form.
And I think that sort of opened him up and allowed him to be very understanding and encouraging to a lot of different people.
My entire legal practice is about pushing them. That's what I do, because I think it's the right thing to do.
The position we take on these questions have social implications.
Can you imagine how moving to hold the brain of someone who lived? Such a privilege.
Find something you love and do it, no matter what anybody says. Just do it.